So, what have we got here? So we have, Mancy, and this is Calamansi Juice Premium.
Yes.
So what is Calamansi Juice?
So Calamansi is the Philippine lemon or the golden lime. Mm-hmm. It's pretty much indigenous to the Philippines, high in vitamin C, mm-hmm. high in antioxidants. More antioxidants than a lot of citruses that are here in the United States. And, you know, the vision is just to bring that out here, have something that's truly enjoyed, refreshment, high class, tart and sweet, something you can't find.
No, so now, I've had a chance to try the product because I've seen it at trade shows before, but most people have not. How are you communicating this to people who have not tried the product, don't know what they're going to get?
Well, I will say this. In our packaging, which we just launched this week, it's totally different, where if you look at that packaging, you see a little fruit that looks actually like one of these, mm-hmm. and you know that it's something different. It's the educational property, no question about it.
Can we see
it looks like one of these. I mean, literally.
Show that for the camera.
So that's how small it is.
Yeah.
Even smaller, you know. And these things, when you cut it up, has that tangerine inside, and that's what we kind of emulated on that packaging.
Right.
Paula was actually here a few seconds ago. Mm-hmm. Her and her team pretty much just put that vision onto that bottle, and I think it's
really
done so much. Millions of things.
So when Paula was working on this and you were talking with her, what were some of the things you were hoping to bring out for the branding?
Well, when you see this instantly, you know that it's a lemon, a citrus, right? But what type of citrus? And when you look at that packaging, it's, why is this a green peel? You know, why is it a tangerine inside? All these things that we want to make sure that the consumer sees that. And and I think when you taste it, it's all about the product.
Right.
You know, please.
And now you're prepping for launch.
Yes, absolutely.
Yeah, so you're going to be mostly based here in New York.
Yep.
And tell me a little about that.
Yeah, absolutely. So we're always, you know, boots on the street. Like, we started with our package, our Tetra Pak. This came out literally this week. And BevNet has been amazing. I mean, everybody's been trying. It's like, what is this? The new packaging?
Right.
What is this new flavor? Very, very excited. So we started from New York, you know, in our own backyard, if you say. That's what everybody says it here. And let's see how it goes. I think it's going to do fantastic. People are trying it out. If you're not drinking it cold, you're drinking it warm. And believe me, mm-hmm. cocktails are fantastic. So
yeah. Exactly. And I think that's something you could definitely promote on that cocktail element, because that's what I've been hearing.
It's huge. I mean, we go to all these parties. You're going to have a lime. You're going to have a lemon. Just use this. Trust me. And it's just fantastic mm-hmm. stuff. A tart and sweet, very unique, familiar, but it's really good stuff.
Yeah. And so, you know, what are you, how are you supporting the launch? Do you have a marketing plan in play?
Absolutely. Yeah. I mean, New York is first our backyard. We want to make sure that we go out there, up and down the street, making sure that people see it. We're actually in the Barclays Center also. So, absolutely. So, just back into that cocktail section of it, we're adding rum with this juice, and it's almost like your mojito. And just to show you on that type of scale, if you will, you know, that's the Brooklyn Nets. That's the NBA basketball team, right? Using this type of fruit that's from the other side of the world, but people in the mainstream audience love this juice because it's unique. It's nothing. There's nothing else like that people taste here.
Yeah, absolutely. And so one other group that you've been working with is Excel Foods.
Absolutely.
So tell me a little bit about what's been happening there. I know we heard from Excel on stage yesterday.
Yep. Jordan's incredible. Lauren's incredible. You know, it's a genuine story, to say the least. When I started and I launched with our current previous packaging, they bought into the brand before they knew me. And I thought that was easy. That was an easy partnership. When we finally got in together, talked about our values, it worked out very, very well. And I'm pleased to see that, you know, where we are today.
Right. And so, you know, now I know that this is not your first BevNet Live either. And
so
I'm kind of curious a bit more about, you know, how it feels to take this journey from, you know, where it was several years ago to now.
Yeah.
Can you talk about that?
So I don't know if I'm old, but I'm BevNet Showdown 9, and we're at 15 today, right? And the things that I learned from the beginning, I see these guys and how I progressed as well. I mean, as much as I love to give information to give them, that's the same thing when I was in their shoes. People are giving information to me. And I think schools like BevNet Beverage, right in the beginning, the beverage school, to this platform, you see all the CEOs, founders, co-founders, and getting all that knowledge and that community is incredible, because we're all fighting that same, you know, vision to bring our, you know, beverage, if you will, out to the public.
Yeah, and you know, I think one thing we've been hearing on stage a lot today is about the challenges to come, and
always.
You know, there's always going to be mistakes that are made. So, what's one thing that you you did early that you would give as advice to other entrepreneurs that are in your shoes?
I think networking is one, building a team two, It's all about minimizing risk, right? And things like this is when you talk to these guys, you see the risk that they take. You know, I'm trying to build a category, right? Monty is building a category that doesn't exist. But if you come back 15 years ago with coconut water, obviously with Mike Kirbin and Vitacoco, nobody knew what coconut water was 15 years ago, right? But look at it today. And I think that we're kind of doing that same trajectory, if you will, understanding that this comes from another side of the world, the Philippines, where coconuts come as well. And why can't we do the same thing?
Yeah, great. Charles, well, thank you so much.
Amen.
Going to give this back to you. And I will see you around for the rest of the show.
Give me that.
Thank you.